स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू विद्या मिराट। दिस वीडियो इज मेड फॉर क्लास 6 ऑन चैप्टर नंबर 8 डेसिमल्स एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू एक्सरसाइज 8.2। लेट्स बिगिन विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। नाउ हियर इफ यू सी यू आर गिवन थ्री फिगर्स ए बी एंड सी एंड वी विल कंप्लीट द बिलो टेबल वंस टेंस एंड हंड्रेड्स एंड रिप्रेजेंट दैट नंबर इन ए डेसिमल फॉर्म। इफ यू लुक एट द ए प्लेस देयर इज नो वंस सो वी विल राइट जीरो। हाउ मेनी टेंस आर देयर? Two full places are tens and six dots represent the hundredth place. So answer comes to 0.26. Next, B part. There is full one box and there are other box which makes up of three rows are there and there are eight dots. So it represents ones is only one, tenth is three, hundredth is eight. So 1.38 is your required decimal. C part. There is one full box, so once you have two complete rows of tens, two in the hundred, there are eight dots, so 1.28 is your required representation. Question number 2. Write the numbers given in the following place value table in a decimal form. Now information is given to you, we know how to convert it into the decimals. Let's begin with it. So we know ones, tens, hundreds, they are on the left hand side of the decimal, and tenths, hundredths, thousands, they are representing on the right hand side of the decimal. So let us see. Now 003, it will remain as 3. 2 is there written on the 10th place, so 2 upon 10. 5 is written as 5 upon 100. So convert it into decimal. 2 upon 10 will become 0.2. 5 upon 100 will become 0.05. Now see, here you have two zeros in the denominator. So what did I explain you? Now you will count these zeros and move towards the left hand side from your right. But there is only one digit 5. How are we going to move the next step? We will put 0 in that missing place. So it becomes 0.05. Add them together, your decimal representation is 3.25. Next number, 100, there is 1, no tens are there. In the case of 1s, it is 2. So 100 plus 2, 102. 6 upon 10 means 0.6. 3 upon 100 means 0.03, which will be written as 102.63. Next, C part, 100s. Place 0 is there, so nothing will come. Under 10's place 3 is there, so 30. Under 1 place nothing is there, so 0. So 0. 100 place 2 is there, that means 2 upon 100. 1000 place 5 is there, so 5 upon 1000. 2 upon 100 will be written as 0.02. 2 places towards your left for the decimal. 5 upon 1000 means 3 places towards the left, so 0.005. Add them together, your answer is 30.025. D part, 211902. So 2 on the 100 place, 200. 1 on the 10th place, 10. 1 on the 1's place, only 1. So 200 plus 10 plus 1 becomes 211. So 9 upon 10 plus 2 upon 1000. 9 upon 10 will become 0.9 and 2 upon 1000 will become 0.002, as you need to move at 3 places towards the left. Add them together, you will get 211.902. Last part, 012241. So let us see there. So it is 10 plus 2, it becomes 12. 2 upon 10, 4 upon 100, 1 upon 1000. 2 upon 10 means 0.2, 4 upon 100 means 0.04, 1 upon 1000 means 0.001. So remember, count the number of zeros in the denominator and shift your decimal towards your left at that number of times, 1, 2 or 3. Add them together, you get your answer as 12.241. Question number 3. Write the following decimals in the place value table form. Now here you know what is your left hand side, what is your right hand side. Your left hand side is ones, tens and hundreds. Your right hand side is tenth, hundred and thousands. Now you are given 0.29. That means Nothing is there on the left hand side, so I will just write 0, 0, 0 on the respective places. After the decimal, it will be 2, 9 and 0 because there is nothing as 1000. 2.08, so 2 is at 1's place, at 10's and 100's, nothing is there, I will put 0. And after the decimal, it is 0 on the 10th place and 8 on the 100th place, so we will write accordingly. 19.60. 9 at the 1 place, 1 at the 10th place, 0 at the 100th place. Nothing is there in the 0, so we are writing. On the right hand side, after the decimal, 6 is on the 10th place and 0 is on the 100th place. And 1000, nothing is there, so we have written 0. 148.32, so 1 is on the 100th, 4 is on the 10th, 8 will come under 1s, 3 will come under 10th, 2 will come under 100th. 200.812, so 2 under 100s, 0 under 10s, 0 under 1s. So after the decimal, 8 under 10th, under 100th, 1 and under 1000th, 2 will come. Like this, we will make the table. Write each of the following as decimals. Now you are given 20 plus 9 plus 4 upon 10 plus 1 upon 100. So, we will convert it into decimals here only. So, 20 plus 9 is 29. 4 upon 10 means 0.4, only one place for the decimal. 1 upon 100 means two places for the decimal, means 0.01. Add them together, you will get 29.41 as your answer. 137 plus 5 upon 100. 137 will remain as 137. 5 upon 100 means 0.05, two places towards your left. Nothing is there in between, missing place, you will write 0. So add them together, you will get 137.05 as your required answer. 7 upon 10, 6 upon 100, 4 upon 1000. 7 upon 10 means 0.7, 6 upon 100 means 0.06. And 4 upon 1000 means 0.004. Add them together, it is 0.764. Next, 23 plus 2 upon 10 plus 6 upon 1000. So, 2 upon 10 means 0.2. 6 upon 1000 means 0.006. As you have to move 3 places towards your left. Add them together, you will get your answer as 23.206. Next, 700 plus 20 plus 5 plus 9 upon 100. So it is 720 plus 5 is 725 plus 9 upon 100 means 0.09. Two places towards your left. Your required decimal place is 725.09. Question number 5. Write each of the following decimal in words. So what we have to do is A part 0.03. So it is, nothing is there on the left hand side, so we will just start with 0.03, the way we speak, the way we write. 1.20, 108.56, 10.07, 0.032, 5.008. Question number 6. Between which two numbers in the 10th place on the number line does each of the following given number lie? 0.06. Now 0.06 will lie between 0 and 0.1. 0.45 will lie between 0.4 and 0.5. 0.19 will lie between 0.1 and 0.2. 0.66, that is, it will lie between 0.6 and 0.7. 0.92, it will lie between 0.9 and 1.0. That becomes 0.10. So 10 we can't write, so it becomes 1.0. 0.57 will lie between 5 and 6. That means 0.5 and 0.6. Question number 7. Write the fraction in the lowest terms. So it is, now let us convert it. Decimals are given to you. We will convert it into the fraction form. How we will convert it? Count the number of digits after the decimal and put that many zeros in the denominator. Now, number 1, it is given to you 0.60. How many digits after the decimal? 2 digits. So, it becomes 60 upon 100. That can be simplified. You get it as 3 upon 5 as your required answer, as it can be divided by 2. 0.05. How many digits after the decimal? 2 places. So, 5 will remain upon 100. It is divisible by 5. Answer is 1 upon 20. 0.75. So, 75 upon 100. It is further divisible. It is 3 upon 4. 0.18. So, 18 upon 100. That gives you, further simplify it and you will get the required answer. 0.25. So, 25 upon 100. Simplify it. It is divisible by 25. So, 1 upon 4. 0.125. Now, here we have 3 digits after the decimal. 3 digit means it will be 1000. 125 upon 1000. Reduce it. It is divisible by 125. You get 1 upon 8. 0.066. So, 066, 3 decimal places. So, 66 upon 1000. It is further divisible. You get 33 upon 500. With this, we finish exercise 8.2. It was very simple. Please understand the concept, how we have to convert it into decimal and how we have to convert it into fraction. Try to keep zeros in the denominator to make it into a decimal form. Very soon, I am going to come with exercise 8.3. Till then, see you children. Goodbye. Take care.